Now, this is a couple of zombie spawners that I made, and I'm gonna blow it up. This one is fixed up, and this one, you know, they spawn, but they come out like so much, like you're just dead. So I gotta figure out the timing of and how the zombies come out, and how you can kill them, and what the time you could when you're killing them. So yeah, I gotta figure out the rounds. Now, these are just circuits that I'm doing now. This is one of the crazy-ass circuit. I don't know what I'm doing with it yet. I was going to make a zombie spawner. I got to change up the timings. As you can see, one light comes off, one light comes on, and then there's some button light there. And it can shut it off and, you know, can shut it on. Kind of stuff. How it works. I'm not gonna be making it. I'm just gonna be explaining how it works. Oh, I keep on pushing the button here, you know? That'd be okay, like it won't break it. Because I'm using a safeguard here. As you can see, a glass. Plus, the power is powering this repeater at 4. And I'm getting power from this at 2, so when this block is there, this will power first before this, so it'll activate this sticky piston here, grabbing this redstone block, activating this clock, you know, and that's how it starts. So going on how this machine works now, these are just pistons, you know, sticking up blocks and redstone blocks, and every time one sticks up, powers up. How only one sticks up is, and let me get to, oh yeah, this is the circuit right here. Now this one here is powered, they're all sticky pistons, this one here is powered, so this powers this first one here, and then when it powers this first one, this one here powers as well, but it just grabs this one, so the next round the power comes onto this one, and then it comes onto this one too, just grabbing this one, so it just grabs, and then it grabs to turn the power, and then it grabs in the next round, it turns it back on the power, and then this one just grabs, and then it grabs it to turn the power the next round, and then it just keeps on doing that. And then at the last one, when it grabs the power, it sends it, this one here, the last one, back, these pistons here, you know, to grab this last one back, because this last one won't retract back right now. I'll show why. And then this is a monostable circuit. These are all like monostable circuits hooked up, right? So there's this one sent on no ticks, right? So it'll still react to zero tick, popping these pistons back into place. So I'll put these on no ticks, no ticks, no ticks. All of these ones are on no ticks, and the block is powering the pistons, shooting back up the blocks, sticky pistons. And then this last one is on 2 clicks, so it can just grab this piston back. And then these redstone wire here is still on the zero tick repeater from this block. It's grabbing the power there. It is going here, back to this piston, shooting this one, stopping the clock, and at the same time it's you know, I have to put it on 4 ticks here, or 3 ticks, you know, for it to actually turn off the torches. 0 tick can't turn off the torches on a block. And then it's going up to all these ones, shooting these back down, resetting this back. And at the same time, this wire here that is shooting this block up is brought up with slabs just to power back up down this piston to shoot this block back up, so this button will work again after everything is done. And this is this circuit, and I'm gonna build another zombie spawner with this type of, and now going back to this one, trying to explain this one properly again. Now this part here is when one powers this one. Well, first, the first one powers this one, right? It powers, it shoots this out, It's on a zero tick, no ticks, so it's going to shoot out the redstone. And then this one here, no ticks, it's going to shoot out the redstone, but the power from this one, I'm grabbing it from this repeater here, going back down to this one, put this one on two, so it will grab back this redstone. So that's how this one operates, and then it goes back around from when that one powers, shuts that one off, and then this one powers, shuts this one off, and then this one powers, shuts that one off, it's in the down below, and then this one powers, shuts this one off, it's up below, you know, and then down below, up below, you know, and then that's how this one works, right? So that's how I'm going to be doing some of the circuits on that stuff. Now this is a circuit I have no clue like what I'm going to do with this circuit, but it's a circuit. It shoots the double piston, it just shoots out the, let me show you what it does. It does that, and then it brings them back. Double piston, lock spitter, vertical up, you know. It is a piston powering this block, which is powering this piston first, right? And at the same time, it's powering this line at the back, right? Whereas there's a piston here underneath with a monostable circuit, shooting this one, giving this one the shooting action for the monostable. And then these four is bringing it back, this power right here, the monostable circuit. It's like a double reactor, brings it back. So let's see. And it just works, I don't know why. Actually, I can build this one right here. Show you. So you two pistons. That one's like that. I think that's one. That one's like that. That one's like this. Piston underneath. Lock on the top. The redstone wire. And we need a repeater to power this, right? Because it needs to power this redstone wire. There's three of them. You could put three of them on four ticks, but we'll put three as the fastest. And then this one is on no ticks. Just going all the way back up. And this one going all the way back up too. And we're going to add a button. Have a button here like this. Oh yeah, I want a piece up there. And when it has a piece and go like that. Yeah, that's one crazy circuit. And this is another circuit I wanted to use on, found it on YouTube circuit. This one's pretty easy, just the three blocks here, two. That gets the power from this this redstone dot, and at the same time gets the power two from this repeater, and at the same time this shuts off and turns back on, so causes that, which I don't know why, but it causes that. Now this is another like weird circuit. I don't know what I was gonna do with this circuit. There's a dot there powering this at two at the same time. There's something like that one, you know, powers this off, but it's gonna be powered on. Right, and let's see what it does. That's what it does. This circuit. It's weird. What are you gonna do with this circuit? See, there's another the circuit here. You can do something with this circuit, but I just don't know what. And I'll build this circuit since the dot there, wire there, and you want the two dots. However, I still don't know what I'm gonna do with this circuit. Because I really don't know how to make the circuit work off anything else but the button at the moment. So there's two, and like that. And what's gonna happen if I put this there? Oh, I just push it. And just throw on the torch and kaboom! What was I trying to do here? I was trying to do something here, I just don't know what I was trying to do here. Where do I get the power? Oh yeah, need to put a block there. That's how we get the power. I don't know why I was making that for. I've already seen some good stuff like that. Is there some circuitry? Oh, these smart pistons. I used the torch there with the repeater. Repeater powers this dot, and then I just brought the line up with slabs. And I can just dissolve them like this. I was going to use that for like a wood fire, so cobblestone, big wall makers or wall makers or something. Be a little faster this one, just using slabs. It all goes at one time. This one's called glitchy. I saw this one on YouTube too as well. Smart piston. These are some clocks, redstone clocks. I don't know what you're gonna do with the clock, like throw it on a piston to go like that. And a repeater going into a dot there. It's the other redstone clock there. This power. So the repeater powers this dot, shutting this off, goes around a little circle. You know, this one, same old little thing. This, I don't know what the hell I was doing with this. That's stupid. Yeah. Then there's just a repeater, pistons, I don't know what I was doing with this guy there. Oh, there's this clock here. It gets the power from this thing here, sends the power through this dot, powers back it, feeding back to the piston, and always giving this power when it's turned on. Weird clock. Make it go a little slower. master. It has to be on two. It's not gonna work. It's just gonna do that. And it's gonna be stuck there, so. Now this clock is always working. I don't know why it's always going on and off. It's a nice clock. It uses a comparator. I've done a clock like this before. Circuits I'm trying to look to see if I have anything here that looks useful. This is from the 3x3 doors from Mumbo Jumbo. I just put some part here. I was thinking I could use the circuit for something, but I don't know. And this part of the circuit I want to use too, I don't know why. Four by four doors. They're nice. I did a fix on these, so. But it looks like only one side's complete. So the closing side is done on one side, but not the opening, so. And I just used the regular, trusty old. What do you call those things again? I'll remember the name, I'd have forgot. They're called T-flip-flops. Yeah, that's the name. And I'm just trying to make a slime elevator. Well, this is what I was coming up myself when I was trying to make one. And then I looked up on YouTube, you know, I was setting up repeaters and torches. I didn't know what to do. Wait, first, and then I made this too. It's another slime elevator. This one with doors and stuff. Same as the slime elevator I made there. Except the doors always remain closed. You know, with the power on, it's just when the power comes on, it's sent on with a pulse extender. So the power goes off for a long period of time, so it just turns off every time I go down there. And this one's set up on a pulse extender too. So basically, it's just all you have to do for the type of door. Look at this. This is made from FedEx Gaming, and it's a slime elevator. It goes all the way up to the top. See, you know, it's not perfect because I'm on the PS4. Not every time I go all the way up there. Majority of the time I do. Let's say, 9 out of 10. A couple of times I haven't. I just added a little installment to his or add-on. I still carried this his thing here and put a slab there, but I put this on 4 and I added a pusher out. So it pushes you out, you don't fall back in. I don't know what I was building here on a flat map creative. Just redstoning stuff. I'm still trying to figure out how to make this smaller. Let's turn on this button. Oh, that doesn't look that good. That doesn't look like it's working at all. An E. Okay, a Z. An O. An M. A B. An I. And an E. Spell zombie, and it'll keep on doing that. And then see, go back to the Z. Already showed me doing something like this, so I could turn it off. Maybe it's stuck on one of those. I gotta figure out how to do some of the circuitry properly. That one is the one I majorly want to do a zombie kind of thing with. Some cool circuitry. Now I'm doing some sort of double screen digit thing here. Just trying to make a compact single counting screen. My own kind. A little bit bigger. I'll do one later. I have one ready. Wait, let me see. Not there. Yeah. 15. The clock's not going yet. It's on, the same type of circuit that I made there. No, this one will go. I don't know what I power this. This one will go on one when it powers. And then zombies will come out. This one will go on. I haven't so much problems there because it's just done that. This one goes on 2, and then it goes all the way to 15, because there's 15 waves. Like, let's look at this one. I didn't put a count there. 1, 2. I'll just look at the number and see. It's a 9. 9. This one looks 13. Yeah. I could make this smaller. This would be a little bit easier to make. It's just 1 8 screen and then one screen. Zombie spawner that. Not going to try and, you know, all these dispensers in this small room. I forgot that the zombies are kind of difficult. Not like COD, not like Black Ops. Running around in circles is kind of hard with a sword. And I don't know what I was doing here. There's no more other circuits I've got in here. I'm gonna start making my own circuits. I was trying to make some circuits, but this is the crap I'm doing all day, just stupid stuff. And this does like a triple piston extender. But the thing is, I make it exactly the way it is right there in a different place and it doesn't work. It's only working here. So I don't know why. So it just gets me upset. I don't like this. I don't know what I'm doing with that. That's it for now.